See, you all told these lies about who King James was.
What picture just you like, have of King
like,
James?
Hey, just like, watch
Where's
this,
King
watch
James
this,
picture?
Watch this. What picture you have me show
Where's
me of King,
King James,
James
picture?
Not who I said.
Brito!
Where's King your James picture to prove what I said?
Brito!
So you don't have nothing to prove, right?
Where's King James picture?
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15.
You got the book.
Where's King James picture?
Here he is right here.
Where is
There's King James. Where's you see that? That's King James right down the front. A black man.
That's Haile Selassie.
That's
Haile Selassie.
Bro, how you doing? Come on up and talk to us, man. How you doing, bro? So, bro, let me ask you a question. Who are you according to the Bible?
You know exactly who I am. You show what I'm standing
on. Huh?
You know exactly who I am.
Who are you?
You see what I have around my neck. You see how I'm adorned.
What you got around your neck?
Yes, brother.
You have an ark around your neck.
Speak to me.
So, you say who you say you know who you are, then who are you according to the Bible?
Child. Speak, brother.
No, I'm asking you, who are you according to the Bible?
Tell me who I am, brother.
Okay, let me ask you a question. When it comes to you knowing who you are, right? Are your ancestors, did your ancestors come over here on slaves?
Your skin look just like mine, you tell me, brother.
Bro.
Hey, shalom, Bob. What's your name?
Amson.
Hey, my name you want to throw that you.
What's going on, guys?
Hey, what we're doing is teaching our people who they are according to the Bible.
And according to the Bible, our history, our origins come from this Bible. This is a record of our people who came off those slave ships.
Which Bible?
The King James Version.
No good.
Hey, we're going to prove it.
No good.
That's the one thing about us.
Who is King James?
Hey. Right now, like I just said, we're gonna show you who you are according to this Bible. Let me finish
before
my point.
Before we start, we gotta set the foundation.
Yes,
we
are all setting the foundation.
So listen.
First of all, you didn't want to tell us your nationality or where you come from, but now you want to dictate to
nationality,
us how we're gonna teach.
You know what nationality does? What? Nationality is division. Nationality.
So you want to be joined with everyone?
Hold on. Nationality is division. You know what division means? What is division is?
Hey, I'm gonna show you what God
when
did.
You divide, right? When you can divide a people.
Do you, let me ask you something.
When you can
did you
divide
come up
a people.
Here to teach us,
you look just like my dad. My dad who fathered me, you look just like him.
Right.
So if you look just like my dad at the end of the day, you know how I can separate me, you, and my dad, and my progeny? Is what?
I'm waiting on you to tell me. I'm waiting on you to finish.
Ideology. That's what we're going to do.
Leviticus chapter 20 and verse 26. And ye shall be holy unto me, for I the Lord am holy.
You know what the word holy means? Separate.
Holy is a Latin word.
God separated the nations. Understand that.
Holy is a Latin word.
Did you understand what I said? God separated the nations. You know, he created 18 nations on this earth, and he chose one to be his people. So you know what we're doing? We're teaching our people that they are the children of God. You understand? And this is how we prove it. We prove it through this Bible. We don't just sit up here and talk. We actually gonna prove it according to this Bible. Cause you know what we've been taught? That this was a white man's book. We've been taught that.
Bring it
up. White man's book. We're gonna show you that this is our book and that the Bible has nothing to do with the white man other than the fact that he's the enemy of God.
Why name the King James?
King James was a black man.
That's right.
No, you don't know that.
Right.
You know, just the same way that they gave us the image of Christ being white, but what color
is King James?
Hold on, let me ask you, what color is Christ?
What is King James?
I'm asking you something simple. What color is Christ? Because right now we're not teaching King James, we're teaching the Bible.
That's right.
Who is King James?
You don't want to answer that question?
Who is
King
James?
You don't want to answer that question? We'll move on without
Who was King James?
Hey, I'm going to show you our people that they are the people of the book. Give me Deuteronomy 28:1. Give me that fact. Give me Deuteronomy 1:1 so we can show you who this Bible is speaking to.
Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1. Uh-huh. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
So Moses is speaking to the children of Israel. Give me 28:15. I'm going to show you that we are the people of this book. And that this book is written by our ancestors.
Who is King Read. James?
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15.
Bring it on!
He was the last who black king ruling James? Scotland, Britain, and France.
Teach!
That's who King James was. King he was James? The last black king fighting against the Roman Catholic Church.
Right.
It's not two King James.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15.
See, you don't talk these lies about who King James
what
was.
What picture just you like, have of King
like,
James?
Hey, just like, watch
Where's
this,
King
watch
James
this,
picture?
Watch this. What picture you have me show me that King James, James picture? Not who I said.
Bring it up!
Where's King your James picture to prove what I said?
Bring it up!
So you don't have nothing to prove, right?
Where's Bring. King James picture?
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15.
You got the book.
Where's King James
oh,
picture?
Here he is right here.
Where is
There's King up? James. Where's you see that? That's King James right there on the front. A black man.
That's Haile Selassie.
That's
Haile Selassie.
Hey, what does the book say?
That's Haile Selassie.
Do you read what the book says?
That's not King James. That's not King James there.
You know That's what? You know what? You know what? You just don't, bro. Don't be simple. You know, I hate when our people be simple as hell. Watch the brief.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses.
All these what?
All these curses.
Is a curse a good thing or a bad thing? A curse is a bad thing. It's an evil. God said, I'm going to send this great evil upon our people for not keeping these laws, statutes, and commandments.
What's the word?
Read.
What's the word curse in Hebrew?
Hey, I'm not here to be no Google
what is the word curse?
For you. Read.
What is the word curse
All
in Hebrew?
All these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So God said he was going to send curses
in Hebrew,
on our
what
people.
Is the word curse?
So let's find out some of these
what
curses.
What is the root word hey. In Aramaic of curse?
I don't know, brothers. Let me ask you a question.
Do y'all what know what color curse is? What is the root word of Aramaic and curse?
Huh?
And
you don't know what color is Christ?
Oh, yeah.
What color is Jesus?
Black.
Hey, all praises. What you say color Christ is?
Thought you was a rod back home?
Hey, so you think Christ is black. Let me ask you something. Could you prove it in the Bible?
Yes.
What scripture?
I don't know what verse, but I know you can prove it in the Bible.
Yeah, but I'm asking you. If somebody asked you to
them
prove it.
Them young lads.
If somebody asked you to
you
prove it,
talk
would
to
you know the scripture?
Them young lads.
What scripture tells me what color Christ is?
Them young lads.
No, let's see if this
Let
king
them travel
know,
their way.
Know what scripture is.
You talk to me.
Oh, you don't
you talk
know?
Talk to me.
Oh, God, you the devil.
You
the
talk to
scripture.
Me.
Give me your
What is the root word of curse
I'm show
in
you,
Hebrew?
I'm going to show you who you are, king.
What is the
I'm
root
show you
word
exactly
of
who you are.
What is the root word of
Mark,
curse in Hebrew?
Mark chapter 4 and know. Verse 15.
He don't know.
And these are they by the wayside.
Those are little kids, our people, that was by the wayside.
Bring it out.
Where the word is sown.
And when the word of God is being sown.
What is Hebrew?
But when they have heard, Satan cometh immediately.
What is this brother right here?
Satan cometh immediately.
Let's
Stop
wait.
Acting like the damn devil.
Teach.
I love young people coming up here to hear the word of God, and you want to run them off? For what?
What is you
what
talking about?
What you want to run them off for?
To
hear the wickedness that's coming
no
out your
good.
Mouth? You ain't said nothing that's important yet.
Because
you don't want
to
accept who the color Christ is. You don't want to accept who King James is.
Teach.
All you want to ask me
King
is,
James.
What is this?
Where
what is that? Let me
picture?
Ask you something. What is your
picture?
Nationality?
Where
who
is
are
King
you?
Picture?
You say you're a
what
king.
You have there?
Prove it.
What you have there?
Listen, prove it.
Where
can
is
you
King
prove
James?
Anything?
Where is picture?
Can you prove anything?
Where is King James
no.
picture?
You can't prove a thing, can you?
Where is
can
King
you
James
prove
picture?
Anything? In you? You can't prove
where is
it. We just gave it to you. We just gave it to you. You want to see it again? Can you open your eyes and see? Can you open your eyes and see? Hey, can you open your eyes and see? Can you open your eyes and see?
That's not King James picture.
How would you know?
Who is this
what,
man
what do you
there?
Want to see? A
who
white
is that
man?
Picture there?
Do you want to see a white
who
man?
Who is that picture
Our
there?
People foolish as hell.
Who is that picture?
Hey, go back to Deuteronomy 28:15. Now, I'm going to show you something.
Who is that
Deuteronomy
picture there?
Deuteronomy 28:28. This is one of the curses that came on our people.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 28. The Lord shall smite thee with madness.
The Lord
shall
do what?
Smite thee with madness.
That's what our people do. Smite with madness. Because you know what's madness?
You're talking
when
about
the people.
Bible?
No, yes, we're talking about the Bible. God said he'll smite you with madness. Because you know why? Because this
Bible.
Is our Bible. Watch this. How did we get here? How did we get here? I'm going to authenticate it right now. How did we get here?
You're talking
did we get
here
on slave ships?
Hear.
Guess what? I'm talking to all those who might want to listen.
No,
since
no.
you want to sit here and come up
you?
Here and be an example, I'm going
to
show you right now. I'm going to authenticate it. We came over here on slave ships, right? Give me Deuteronomy
28.
Bring it on!
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt.
The word Egypt means house of bondage. Let's prove that.
The house of bondage. 20. You know what Egypt is?
Exodus chapter 20 and verse 2. I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
God brought us out of the land of Egypt.
Show me Egypt in the
Bible. Out of the house of bondage.
Show me Egypt in the Bible. Read it again for the summer to hear.
Show me Egypt outside
the house of bondage.
Show me Egypt in the Bible.
I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Brought us where?
Out of the land of Egypt.
Brought us where?
Out of the land of Egypt.
Where is your Egypt? Read.
Out of the house of bondage.
Out of what?
The house of bondage.
You wanted to hear Egypt out of the Bible. Guess what? You heard it, and guess what? You want to humble down. You just want to be a nigga acting simple.
What Egypt mean?
So the word, what Egypt mean? Tell them what Egypt mean.
I am the Lord thy God, which I brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Oh, my God.
Out of the house of bondage.
What does Egypt mean?
Out of the house of bondage.
What does Egypt mean?
Out of the house of bondage.
The word Egypt means house of bondage. What? Go back to Deuteronomy 28, 68.
Egypt means house of bondage?
House of bondage.
Chapter 28 and verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt,
into bondage or slavery
again with ships.
With what?
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
That's your authentication. Black people came over here on slave ships.
That's right.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again.
And guess what, black man? You ain't seen your homeland again. Read.
And there.
Right here in America.
Ye shall be sold.
What was that simpleton done?
Sold.
He was sold.
Unto your enemies.
We were sold to our enemies. Read.
For bond men.
For slave men.
And bond women.
And slave women. Read.
And no man shall buy you.
And no one has been able to save us out of our captivity.
Right.
We want this Bible authenticated. Guess what? These curses authenticate who we are according to the Bible. We are the Israelites. Give me verse 48.
Deuteronomy.
These are the curses that fell on our people.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 48. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
We're going to serve who?
Our enemies.
We got to serve our enemies. Read.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
The Most High sent us for our rebellion. For our rebellion against his laws, statutes, and commandments.
Which the Lord shall send against thee in hunger.
In what?
In hunger.
So guess what? The very food that y'all burn, you got to go to your enemies. Those are your enemies that you're going in there being served to.
And in thirst.
The very water, the beer, the liquor that you want to drink, guess what? You got to keep going to your enemies for it.
And in nakedness.
The very clothes on your back, you got to go to your enemies for it.
And in want of all things.
Anything and everything. You want a marriage license, you got to go to your enemies. You want an education, you got to go to your enemies. Hey, the cars you drive, you got to go to your enemy.
Bring it out!
This Bible is a history book. This Bible is the truth. And our people don't want the truth. All they want to do is want to show us that they think they know something.
Bring it out!
They want to show us that they got some type of knowledge. But guess what? Their knowledge is nothing but foolishness unto God.
Right.
Nothing but foolishness. If our people knew the answers, guess what? They would do something to get our people out the conditions they're in. But they don't want the answer to our problems. They don't want the answers to how we come off and under the hand of our enemies.
Right.
Because you know why? They're happy in captivity. They're happy being slaves.
Teach!
Ain't no real black man should ever want to be a slave.
Right.
A real black man will stand up for his people. He don't come against his people. He definitely don't come against the prophets of God. We ain't out here asking for no money. We ain't out here asking you to, hey, come and join us. We out here to warn you. Warn you that destruction is coming. But the black man, being as simple as he want to be, always want to show us that he got some knowledge. But let's see what God said. Give me Hosea 4 and 6. Because guess what? Our people don't got no knowledge. That's why we're in the damn ghettos now. That's why you serving your enemies now. Because we don't have no knowledge. But guess what? You want to keep on running your mouth like you got some. What did God say about your knowledge?
Hosea chapter 4 and verse 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
What is the black Native American, Hispanic and Native American, and what?
My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
The black man is destroyed for the lack of knowledge. That's why you're at the bottom of society. That's why you're getting your ass shot down in these streets.
Teach!
That's why you out here voting for somebody who don't care about you.
Bring it out!
How are you gonna vote for somebody who hates your guts? How are you gonna vote for somebody who ain't never did a damn thing for you?
Right.
two rich white men is gonna have a solution for black people?
Read out.
The only solution they got is how to stay rich, how to stay above you.
Read
it
out.
Their foot on your neck. Read.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge.
What did the simpleton do?
Rejected knowledge.
When the knowledge of the Bible was coming out, giving him his true nationality back, showing him that, hey, he's a god on this earth. He want to be a king. How can a king be a king in a ghetto?
Bring it out.
Who's a king in a damn ghetto?
Teach!
When did anybody become a king in the ghetto?
If you're
a king in the ghetto, do something for your people.
What?
Do something for your people. Raise them up out of that. Give them a solution. Show them how to come out the ghetto.
What's the ghetto?
That's where we live.
What's the ghetto?
Our people in the ghetto.
So where did Jesus dwell?
That's where the ghetto is. It's the place where the Jews dwell. Watch up. I'm going to show you who you are.
Who is Yeshua?
We're going to show you who you are.
Where did Yeshua do his work?
Hey, we're going to show you who you are. Since you think you're a comedian, give me Exodus 7. I'm going to show you that you ain't no damn Egyptian. I'm going to show you that.
Who is Yeshua?
Exodus chapter 7.
You read it from verse 11.
The one thing I'm going to show you is that you ain't no Egyptian.
11
to 7.
Exodus chapter
11.
Who is Yeshua?
He's going to answer.
Verse 7.
He's not talking to me.
Listen.
Who is Yeshua?
Exodus chapter 11, verse 7. But against any of the children of Israel shall not a dog move his tongue.
Against any of the children of Israel shall not a dog move his tongue.
Who is Yeshua?
Against man or beast.
Uh-huh.
That they may know how
like
that the Lord
like
does
microphone.
Put a difference between
like
the
microphone.
Egyptians.
God puts a difference between
you like
who?
Microphone.
The Egyptians.
You the love of microphone.
The Egyptians and who?
The
that's
Egyptians
what you is.
And Israel.
You the lover of microphone and you the lover of camera.
And Israel. Hey, we're not no damn
you
Arab.
Love of microphone and camera.
We are the Israelites. God's chosen people.
You
the
love of microphone
that's
and camera. You the Isaiah, love of microphone and camera.
Bring it out.
Woe to them
what
that go
about?
Down to Egypt for help.
You don't have what? No knowledge.
Woe means destruction to them that go down to Egypt for help. Read.
What is
woe to them that go down to Egypt for help.
Hey, that's just another word for
who is Kemet?
And stay on horses and trust in chariots.
You don't know
what
your history.
What does he trust in? He trusts in his
you don't
oppressor.
Know your history.
You trust in your oppressor.
Why are you teaching
that's
these
what?
People?
Let me ask you something.
What are you teaching these people?
Let me ask you, what are you teaching?
You know what
you
I'm teaching them?
Teach!
Spirituality.
Oh, what is spirituality?
Not no Bible
what's
that came from a man.
Hey, what's spiritual?
Bring
what
it up.
Nicene Council?
I'm asking you a question.
What is Nicene Council?
Don't ask me, don't answer a question with a question. Answer. What is spiritual?
You know
said you teach him spiritual. Yes, I do. I'm
going to
show you right now. But you saying, hey.
You said what?
Back a little more. Back
hey,
more.
You say you teach him spirituality.
Don't get us out of
he fine.
You said what?
He fine.
He's fine.
Hey,
all right.
You say you teach him spirituality.
No, I know I'm
what
good.
Is spiritual? You teach him spirituality. What is spiritual?
Do you
got the floor.
Do you know what spirituality
hey, you got the floor.
Do you know what spirituality is?
Hey, I'm going to give the answer after I hear what you got to say.
Spirituality is the energy that flows between all us ancestry and DNA. That does not conform to any type of religion, any type of precept, any type of preconceived notion that them King James or anybody else has
your spirit, before. Your spirituality says you can do whatever you want.
That's not what
that's,
I
that's
said.
That's exactly. So it doesn't
not,
conform,
not
it doesn't
a,
conform
not
to anything,
mind.
Right?
You're not of a sound mind.
What is it going to do for our people?
How can you be of sound mind?
I'm asking you, what is it going to do for our people?
How can you be a solid man? Lineage,
what is it going to do for our people?
You cannot understand.
Hey, what is it going to do for our people?
How can you be a son
I'm asking you a simple
lineage
question. You're
when you
teach
can't
me?
Even understand basic logic.
Look, you don't understand what the hell you said.
You don't have no good sense.
For we know that the law is spiritual.
What's spiritual?
The law is spiritual.
What's spiritual?
The law is
teach!
Spiritual.
Hey, that's what's spiritual. The
that's
laws
right.
Of God.
That's spiritual.
Who is God?
Guess what?
Who is God?
The God of Israel. That's who God is.
The God
is.
Of what?
Of Israel.
Of God of Israel is the
that's
only God?
What? That's the only true God.
You crazy.
That's the only true God.
God
the Most
Israel.
High God.
Who is the
that's
God
what?
Of Israel?
But your God is what?
What does he look like?
Your God is one of the Egyptian
what
gods,
What does
God
of Israel look like?
Your God is one of the Egyptian
what
gods,
what does God of Israel look like?
Oh, you want to know?
Yeah.
Hey, guess what? We're going to give
what
you an
what does God of Israel
look
like? Show me in your Bible 79. What God looked like.
Daniel chapter 7
uh-huh.
and verse 9.
Uh-huh.
I beheld till the thrones were cast down,
uh-huh.
and the Ancient of Days,
that's God,
did sit.
Uh-huh. Our God has a body. He ain't no spirit.
What are you talking? No, 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 no.
Whose garment was white as snow.
His garment was what?
white as snow.
If you have a garment, that means you have a body. Read.
Oh, my
and
God.
And the hair crazy. Of you his crazy. Head.
And the hair of his head.
Like
if,
the pure.
This man said, if you have
his
a garment,
the hair of his see, head was
listen.
The hair Damn. Of his head like
you
the pure. Wool.
Let me ask you one question, brother. Who got woolly hair on this
if
earth?
If you have a garment,
who got
you have
woolly
body?
Hair? Question. If he got clothes on, he got a body.
Teach.
What is that saying,
you
bro?
You crazy.
Oh, it got it.
You don't bro, know.
Right. You don't understand
do you
that.
Know what
but
the
you
word
help me understand your
spirituality. Do you know what the word garment means
yes,
in Hebrew?
Clothes. It's clothing, brother.
What does garment
it's clothing,
mean in Hebrew?
Brother. Hey,
what is the word
right.
garment
this ain't hard,
mean
brother.
Hebrew.
Brother, this ain't hard.
You crazy.
Watch up. What does garment mean in English?
What does we speak garment in English. Mean in Hebrew?
Hey, we speak in English.
You know right. what
we can. Hey, are you, hey, watch up.
You don't know
watch
what Hebrew
I'm
going
ask you something. I'm going ask you something.
What
something.
Does the word garment
do you
garment
understand
mean
this?
In
read
Hebrew?
The from top.
What does
Daniel
the word garment mean in Hebrew?
Verse 9.
The black man can't understand
what
this verse.
What does the word garment mean in Hebrew?
I beheld till the thrones were cast
down. Tell me.
And the ancient
the man said
of
you got a garment that have you have body.
So this is the Ancient of Days. The Ancient of Days is God. Hey, the Bible is giving you the description of
you,
God.
You break
it
yourself.
It's not no spirit.
You break
Read.
Yourself.
Whose garment
he
was white as snow.
And he had a garment on that was white in color.
Why
white
wearing,
as snow.
Why you wearing
so he
that?
Was wearing a beautiful white garment.
Wow.
And the hair of his
a
head.
Beautiful white
and
garment.
The hair on his head.
Like the pure wool.
Like the what?
Pure wool.
Guess who got woolly
care.
Hair?
Listen, everybody
pure
heard all that.
Pure wool is the hair of Negro. And guess what? Christ
what
looked like
Negro?
His father.
What is Negro?
So let's go with Christ.
This man
like.
Said Negro. What is Negro?
Hey, guess what?
What is Negro?
The so-called black man
what is
called a Negro.
You know what?
Free.
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14. Hey. His head.
Sign
and
down.
His hair.
Take that
or
camera
white,
down.
White
take that oh, speaker down.
This is description.
That man
of Jesus
said Negro. He don't even
no
speak that language.
Pale face.
Of
he's
African.
A black man like this brother,
you know,
but he don't understand that. Read.
His head and his hair were white like wool.
So the hair on his hey. Head and the hair on his face was white in color and wool in texture. So it's fully gray. Read.
You like
as white
man.
As snow. And his eyes were as
you
a
like
flame of fire.
And his eyes were what?
As a flame of fire.
So the whites of his eyes was red in
y'all
color.
Y'all practice this?
Read. And
y'all
his
practice
feet.
This?
His feet gonna be the same color
this
as the rest of his
practice?
Body. Read.
Like unto fine brass.
What
this
color
is
brass?
Practice?
Hey, what color is brass?
This is what y'all
hey,
practice?
What color is brass? All you wanna do
this
is ask
y'all
questions. Because you ain't got no answers.
This
Read.
Is what
the
y'all
color
practice?
Of brass is brown.
Is this what y'all
and
practice?
And his feet. Like unto fine brass.
Uh-huh. What is it
as
that y'all talking about?
They burned in a furnace.
His feet was so
man,
dark.
Get the fuck
it looked like
man.
He burned in a furnace.
Y'all don't
man,
know what
it was
y'all
dark
talking about, man.
Black. That was
take
dark black.
Take that
so guess
take
what?
That,
you know what?
That
we got this wicked Negro out here who think he's an Egyptian.
What
think he's
mean?
Egyptian.
But
guess what? He ain't gonna never prove
what
he's
is
Egyptian.
Negro?
But guess what? We're gonna prove
what
that you came off them slaves.
Hey,
where did you learn when you
fuck out of here?
Watch
we it. Don't want y'all shit
watch
over here. We don't
but
want y'all.
Stay here
we don't want what the fuck y'all talking about.
Bring it out!
Y'all ain't some bullshit no, ass no, niggas.
Bring it out!
Psalms chapter 82
get the fuck
and verse 6.
Here.
I have
y'all
said,
talking about shit.
Ye are gods.
What did the Bible say about the Israelites?
Teach.
Ye are gods.
The Bible said we are gods.
Bring it out!
You don't want that either. Read.
Trash. Get the fuck out of here. You trash,
you,
you trash,
the children
you trash,
of the Most High.
You trash.
We're the children of the Most
oh,
High, God.
Oh, y'all trash, right?
But
you trash.
You shall die like men.
Hey, you trash,
wait, wait,
you
talk again.
You trash.
Because when I hear this simple
the
saying,
you
trash, what
you
God
trash.
Say?
Bring it out.
Man is.
Trash,
I have
trash.
Said,
get the fuck out of
ye
here.
Are gods.
The Israelite man is a god on this earth.
That's
the
right.
Man is a
you
god
ain't
god
shit, you trash.
Hey, guess what? The Egyptians got took down with a stick.
That's right!
The Most High God took the Egyptian down with a stick.
Right.
And guess what? This word take down that simpleton. Give me Proverbs 28:1.
Bring it
out! That simpleton down with the word of God. Hey, and this word of God gonna be here all day. All day long.
Proverbs chapter 28 and verse 1. The wicked flee.
The wicked do what?
The wicked flee.
Uh-huh.
When no man pursue it.
We ain't chasing that, brother. All you wanna do is be on stalker. All he want to be is a little stalker. Run his mouth. He think he knows something, but when his little Egyptian theories get cut down, he's nothing. He's nothing. He don't want to accept that he's a god on this earth.
That's right.
He want to be king of the ghetto. That's all that people ever want to be. They want to represent something that, hey, the Most High, the white man will put you there. to keep you caged, to oppress you, and you want to be king of that. But you don't want to be no real man. You know, it takes a very simple Negro to come up against the words of God. A very simple Negro. But the black man don't want to know what it means to be a real man.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.